invitation I have for you to spend the next 25 minutes with me in the company of some supremely skillful Bulgarian young ladies. Now, what they're doing is called rhythmic gymnastics, and we might reflect later on whether what we're about to see owes more to gymnastics or acrobatics or ballet. It's very like ballet, you'll find. What there's no doubt about is that it's a highly competitive sport. It was in the Olympic Games last year for the first time, but we didn't see these Bulgarian ladies, despite the fact that they are the world and European champions, because they stayed away from the Games, along with most of Eastern Europe. So tonight, a rare opportunity to see them with hoop, ball, ribbon, rope and clubs, not in competition, but in a special gala performance. What do you think? Acrobatics? Definitely not. There must be no acrobatic elements in the sport, say the rules. No moves through the vertical. Even the somersaults are done sideways, you'll notice. The acrobatics are left strictly to traditional gymnastics. No, dance is where it stems from, and I suppose that's why it looks so like ballet. And indeed, they use dance terminology, words like arabesques, jetés, pirouettes, and so on. And of course, tonight, we are not seeing the sport in its usual context, with solo piano or other musical instrument, but with full orchestral arrangement, coloured lighting and special visual effects. It really is a very graceful sport, isn't it? And so essentially feminine. That was Svetomira Filipova, and now here's the current darling of the Bulgarians, 14-year-old Bianca Panova. Amazing Bianca Panova. Astonishing dexterity when you consider that the apparatus, the ball, the hoop and the rest, has to be worked with both hands, and they're throwing them 40 feet in the air. The ribbon, for example, must be a minimum of 6 meters in length. That's 18 feet or so, and just imagine keeping control of that. The secret, of course, is that they start at the age of 6, when they practice 2 or 3 times a week. And then 3 or 4 years later, when they are 9 or 10, the chosen few are devoting their lives to the sport, training for over 9 hours a day in the Bulgarian Rhythmic Gymnastics Center in Sofia. Yes, they've got one of those as well, and it's the setting for the program we're watching now. Quite simply, in Bulgaria, it's taken just as seriously as football. Beautiful, isn't it? Absolutely beautiful. By the way, if you're wondering how the British girls compare with what we're seeing, we showed this program to the British team coach. She was quiet for a bit, she swallowed very hard, and then pointed out that the British team can only get in about 20 hours of practice each week. However, rhythmic gymnastics is coming on well in Britain, she told us. There are now more than 50 clubs and 600 or so enthusiastic practitioners. But frankly, they can but hope they'll be able to do it as well as Yulia Bycheva here with the ribbon. Amazingly, she is only 11 years old.
La place rouge était vide. Devant moi marchait Nathalie. Il avait un joli nom, mon guide, Nathalie. Elle parlait en phrases sobres de la révolution d'octobre. Je pensais déjà qu'après le tombeau de Lénine, on irait au café Pouchki boire un chocolat. La place rouge était vide. Je lui pris son bras, elle a souri. Il avait des cheveux blonds, mon guide, Nathalie. Nathalie. Dans sa chambre, à l'université, une bande d'étudiants l'attendait impatiemment. On a ri, on a beaucoup parlé, ils voulaient tout savoir. Nathalie traduisait Moscou, les plaines d'Ukraine et les Champs-Élysées. On en a tout mélangé et on a chanté.
Well, it's all quite remarkable, isn't it? Athletic, balletic, graceful, skillful. It's all of that, and I hope very much that you've enjoyed watching with me. Now, we're going to finish the programme with a group performance, the ensemble section, which is also a part of the World Rhythmic Gymnastic Championships, which take place in October. Good night to you.